They say everything's bigger in Texas, and that's certainly true of the cars and the hamburgers, but what about the imaginations? That's my question, and I'm here on Spyglass Drive in Austin, Texas, with someone who certainly knows how to answer it. You're about to meet Stef Baduria, who leads this incredible school you can see behind me called Alpha. Imagine this, a school with no teachers. Let's take a look.
So nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you too.
You have a beautiful office right here.
Thank you. Yeah, we call it the locker room.
Yeah, it's exciting to be here at Alpha.
We're so excited to have you. Can I walk you around?
Let's do it. What is your background? Are you an educator by trade?
So I started my career as a fourth grade teacher in a private school. And actually when I was in the middle of my doctorate, I was approached by the LA Galaxy, the MLS team based in LA, to build their school program from scratch for their athletes, make sure they were motivated and hitting their goals.
Well, I can see why you found what you were really looking for working here at Alpha.
I stumbled upon the job description for Alpha, and here I am, loving every second.
So tell me about where we are. What is Alpha?
Alpha is a private school. We serve grades K through 12. Founded here in Austin, Texas, we've expanded to Brownsville, Texas, Miami, Florida, and Denver, Colorado. We promise and commit to every student will love school, learn 2x in 2 hours, and learn life skills. It's important for us that in our definition of love of school, it's not because it's Disneyland fun, but it's because students are able to discover here that they are truly limitless. And the Learn 2x in 2 hours piece, this is really with our academic product, 2-hour learning. And so students get individualized instruction via an AI tutor and adaptive learning apps. It gets kids to learn a lot more efficiently. And this is all backed in learning science and theories that have been around for decades. It's just never been possible to do with the standard classroom model. It's also only done in 2 hours. So our students get to spend 4 hours in the afternoon doing project-based workshops to learn critical life skills like teamwork, public speaking, leadership, grit, giving and receiving feedback. So all those three commitments in one is really our Alpha product.
Sounds like a really ambitious model here, innovating in a whole lot of directions all at the same time.
Yes.
And a lot of people watching this as a remote work vlog might be surprised to see that I'm at a bricks and mortar school. Can you talk to me about the role that remote work plays here at Alpha?
Sure. So we do have our in-person guides who essentially run and operationalize the vision that is Alpha, and they're with the kids every day in the brick and mortar schools. But we also have a robust remote academic team, and they are really the folks who are powering what is 2-hour learning and training the AI tutor and refining it to make sure it works just right for every kid. There's also another side of our remote workers, and that's what I'm calling our life core team. We know exactly what a student should know in math in fourth grade. And we at Alpha realize that same kind of rigor and standardization and objectivity does not exist on the life skill side of things. Mm-hmm. And this is where we spend 4 hours of our day. And so we're trying to build essentially the complement to our learning for the life skills called Life Core. My favorite part is seeing the ambitious things our kids accomplish. Third graders coding self-driving cars. Take seventh graders to a building where venture capitalists work so that they can pitch their product and secure $10,000 in funding. Just wild things that were not for the growth mindset we teach in this building and our awesome motivational guides. These kids would have otherwise just not had the opportunity. So it's pretty special.
How do you find it collaborating with remote coworkers around the world that are helping you bring this vision to life here in Austin?
Yeah, I love it. It's very cool to be in a Zoom meeting with people who every person in the meeting represents a different country and a different perspective. And they bring just a unique talent and skill set because we are from all over the world working on this one shared project and goal. The projects are always being worked on. So while I might be asleep, I have a colleague who is actually awake in a different time zone, and we're literally able to work and improve on these things 24/7.
And I'm hearing you talk about guides and about AI tutors.
Yes.
Can you talk to me about the approach to teachers and to leading classrooms?
We don't have teachers. We do have adults in the building, but they're guides. We call them guides because they do not teach. What we want the guides to do is focus on emotional and motivational support. Every adult looks back and has had one or two people who have changed their life. And so our guides know when they wake up every morning that that is the standard they should be hitting. Every day you should show the kid you're trying to get to know them, you're trying to uncover their interests and passions, and you're trying to unlock their potential and hold them to super high standards. There's an emotional, motivational component that leans into kids' self-confidence, increased self-efficacy, and all of those different variables do impact academic outcomes. Right? We often say two-hour learning is the software, but it's not the silver bullet. It solves 10% of the problem, which is giving every single kid their own individualized one-on-one learning path and tutor who has endless patience, but that student then needs motivation. And that's where we believe really the guides are the core.
What role does AI play in the education space?
Oh goodness, so much. So in two-hour learning, it really is. It's the AI tutor. It's ensuring that the student is in the exact right level of difficulty, not too hard, not too easy. And that's what unlocks the ability for a student to move forward. From a teacher or guide perspective, we very much have an AI first culture. Speaking it to it from a guide point of view, every work unit has an output, and I've created GPTs that the guide can use before they enter the work unit, while they're doing the work unit, and then also to quality check the work when they're done with the work unit. The key of training the GPT is giving it tons of examples. So few shot prompting times, 100. And a lot of human QC, right? We don't implement the GPT and then turn a blind eye and let AI sit in the driver's seat. You gotta make sure there's human QC on the guardrails there as well. Really, using AI well in education is leaning into it versus turning away from it and teaching kids the things that they can do if they leverage AI properly.
Yeah, you're training the first AI native generation.
Right.
How does that feel?
It's pretty incredible, but it's also a huge responsibility, right? We want to make sure the kids know how to use AI, but AI is not always correct. So we have workshops as well on how to use AI, how do you make sure it's actually telling you the right information, not hallucinating.
What kind of academic results are the students delivering?
So we check the kids' learning every single day, making sure that they're hitting their mastered units. So we use state-aligned standardized tests to then validate the knowledge the student just learned. And for us to declare mastery of a grade level and for a student to move forward, the student has to score 90% or higher. Mastery-based is the only way to prevent knowledge gaps, which learning starts to slow down, if not stop, around middle school, high school, and it's because there's too many knowledge gaps from prior years. So our approach really, it builds on itself, and that's why kids can exponentially grow faster.
How do the kids that come through Alpha compare to the national average?
Top 1%.
Top 1%, and not by cramming every single night and having no social life, but actually delivered in just 2 hours.
Correct.
It is truly extraordinary. I'm sure you hear a lot the phrase, the future of education, but you're here living it. How does it feel to be on the forefront of that?
It's exciting. I wake up every morning thinking about the kids who are in our program and the guides who are part of our org. Our job is to make sure we deliver our commitments to them, and I hope that we can just get this in front of as many kids across the country, world, as we can.
Do you think the Alpha model could scale to become worldwide?
Oh, 100%. Every kid can learn more efficiently when they get their own one-on-one, always patient AI tutor. And the life skill side of things too, that's a big part for our Life Core team, is figuring out how can we deliver the quality of workshops that we deliver in our brick and mortar schools in a remote fashion so that students all over the country and beyond, all over the world, can access the quality of our life skills workshops products and not have to be in our Alpha campus.
If someone watching this is invested in what you're sharing about Alpha's vision and wants to be a part of it, what should they do next?
If they're interested in learning more, they can message me on LinkedIn. If they're interested in having their student attend one of our schools, they can go to alpha.school or 2hourlearning.com and learn more.
Well, with you at the helm, I have no doubt that Alpha is going to be on everyone's lips before very long.
Thank you.
Thank you so much for taking the time to connect with me today.
You're
Stefanie,
welcome.
It was wonderful to have you on the show.
Thank you. It was awesome to be here. Thanks, Andrew.
Take care.